like it or not, gaming has become a very important use case for Linux. I know there's a lot of people out there who just don't play video games, don't like video games, don't really understand why SteamOS, the Steam Deck, Proton, all of this stuff is the thing that's actually driving the adoption of Linux, but it is what it is. And for me, I'm a big fan, I've said it plenty of times before, I would not be daily driving Linux if I could not play games on this system. So for me, it is always nice to see when a big game-related change actually gets merged into the kernel, or at the very least, is going to be merged in a soon upcoming release. It's just sitting in the next tree. It's not actually out there in a tag numbered release. NT-Sync driver ready for enhancing Windows gaming with Linux 6.14. So being on Arch Linux, I will be on that basically as soon as that comes out. But for people on things like Ubuntu and things like that, they're going to have to wait a little bit longer. More good equals more better. Yeah. But to actually understand what is happening here, we need to go into a bit of backstory first and talk about why this solution is being used rather than its earlier predecessors. If you've been gaming on Linux for a while, you've probably heard the words async, fsync, or you may have heard both of them because they're both trying to achieve the exact same goal. Oftentimes they are used interchangeably because fsync is a direct successor to async. It does everything async did with a couple of additional bugs, but was intended to be its complete replacement. Now, these had the goal of reducing the wind overhead and thus increasing performance, especially in CPU-bound scenarios. But you're very likely stopped at that explanation because, again, more better, more good. I don't really need to spend 10 hours trying to look into what this actually does. Now, Async and Fsync are both prior attempts to solve what NT-Sync is doing now. So let's go back to 2021 when NT-Sync was first announced. As a basic summary to what follows, we at the Wine Project are looking to introduce a kernel API that will allow us to implement Windows NT Synchronization Object API with at most one syscall per operation, and without managing object state in user-managed shared memory for the sake of performance. I'm hoping to get opinions with this mail as to what such an API should look like, or whether it should be accepted. Obviously, when it comes to a big project like this, you don't want to get started writing everything, and then just say, well, it was just never going to fit in the kernel anyway, so all of that work is completely wasted. I'm sure most of you know, but Wine is the backing to Proton. It is a tool for running Windows applications under Linux. Windows NT has a set of synchronization primitives, essentially all of which are stateful and can be shared between processes. I've written a detailed description of these primitives below. If you'd like to go read all of that, I will link this in the description down below as well. Because these objects can be shared between processors, Wine implements them using a dedicated Wine server process, which receives requests from client processors somewhat analogous to system calls. For example, server requests exist corresponding to release up a semaphore and wait for an object to be signaled. Each server request is a remote procedure call to the Wine server process, wherein data is sent over a socket from the client to the server, and the server performs some operation, then sends a reply back to the client. In recent years, applications, especially high-performance games, have made use of multiple threads. This only happened relatively recently in gaming. There's always been like, hey, put the sound on a separate thread, but like, actual multi-threaded game development is a relatively new thing. People have always tried it, but actually, like, consistently done, and consequently, heavy use of these synchronization primitives. And this led to a bit of a bottleneck developing. So a few years ago, I wrote a set of out-of-tree patches for Wine, colloquially called Async, that re-implements the performance-critical parts of many of these operations on top of the EventFD interface, with NT kernel objects essentially mapping directly to EventFD objects, plus some extra state which lives in shared memory. To a large degree, this results in theoretically equal performance with Windows. Most operations which are understood to compromise one system call on Windows now also compromise one system call to the Linux kernel on Wine. The actual performance improvement is, depending on the application, quite substantial. However, Async has its problems. There are some areas where EventFD just doesn't provide the necessary interfaces for NT kernel APIs, and we have to badly emulate them. As a result, there are some applications that simply don't work with it. It also relies on shared memory being mapped read-write into every application As a result, objects there can easily be corrupted by a misbehaving process. These problems have led to remaining out of tree. Now, of course, there have been like patched versions of Wine on things like the AUR, things like that, that do have these patches, but it's never been in the main Wine thing that you get from your package manager, with the exception of distros that might be doing things they probably shouldn't be doing. As a response to that, they then made another patch set, a second outer tree patch set, the awfully named F-Sync, because it uses futexes instead of event FDs. It also happens to be the next letter in the alphabet, but I feel like that might just be a coincidence. Anyway, it was developed by request on the grounds that futexes can be faster than event FDs, since an uncontended object needs no syscalls. In practice, there is sometimes a positive performance difference, sometimes a negative one, and often no measurable difference at all. It also sometimes makes performance much less consistent. It shares all of the same problems as async, including, to a degree, some inefficiencies when executing contended weights. So it's sometimes better, it's sometimes worse, it's sometimes exactly the same, and then causes additional things to break. So it's not exactly great to use in all cases. With that being said, like async, F-Sync is also available in various different patched versions, and actually has been present in Proton as well. And when they had this back in 2019, they actually opened up a thing to be like, hey, how well does this perform? They were getting some pretty wild numbers. Mins going from 32.6 to 54.53 in Sleeping Dogs, 50 to 70-ish in GTA 5. Not really much of a difference. In Borderlands Game of the Year, again, not much of a difference. So it's very dependent on the game, what it's doing, but in the cases where it's better, it can legitimately be really good. It can be the difference between the game being kind of wonky to it actually being really playable. Or it can do basically nothing. F-Sync, 99.7. Async, 99.46, none, 98.55. Which, you're not going to notice a single frame difference. Now, a year prior to NT-Sync being started, this was opened up on Wine. F-Sync patch for Wine 6.0-RC1 without staging. Basically, someone was trying to bring the F-Sync patches into mainline Wine. And this is the response they got from the developer. No. Not the developer, like, you know, whoever's in charge of Wine, but like the developer of the patch set. No. We're not doing that. And it's not because the patch set is outdated, because they did go and like update stuff and get it all ready and all that stuff, but the issue is it just was not suitable to be upstreamed into the Wine project. But this still left some people confused, so a year after NT-Sync started, this comment was also made. Neither E-Sync nor F-Sync will be accepted into upstream Wine for the following reasons. They rely on use of shared memory to retain object state, which is not robust against misbehaving processes, and hence is not secure either. They do not offer full compatibility with the Windows API, and in practice, break many applications. And no, neither one of these can be fixed within the current design, or I would have done so already. F-Sync is unlikely to be accepted into Wine staging because it represents a significant additional maintenance burden for practically no benefit. In particular, the number of applications that is known to help can be counted on one hand. Furthermore, E-Sync is already a very significant maintenance burden. It has been easily the worst patch set in Wine staging since its induction. And again, this is the developer of the patch set saying, no, this patch set just is not suitable for upstream Wine. Not only is it not ready, but there's not really any way to make it ready without further additional changes outside of Wine. Now, this takes us to the new solution being deployed, NT-Sync. NT because of the Windows NT kernel. Let's introduce a module, call it NT-Sync. I'd propose WineSync, but in theory, I guess this could be used to some other translation layer, not that I know of any. This would create a char device slash dev slash ntsync which supports a set of IOCTLs. My reasoning here is that we should modularize this feature since it's meant for a specific and not ubiquitous program, and I'm presuming that this is the best way to expose something from a module. Each IOCTL matches up relatively closely to an ntsyscall. Each IOCTL on an object is atomic and totally ordered with respect to other IOCTLs on the same object. The list of the IOCTLs is as follows. Feel free to go and read the ideas that are here. I don't want to read all of this, frankly, and I think it's kind of outside the scope for what I actually want to talk about today. Basically, the idea is to make a set of changes that makes Linux look more like the Windows Synchronization API so that things can be more easily matched up. That's pretty much the TLDR. Now, for a couple of years, nothing was really heard about this. I'm sure if you paid attention to the Linux kernel mailing list, you would have seen, like, changes made here and there and all that stuff, things, RFC, all that fun stuff. But, at least publicly, not really anything. That was until November of 2023.
My name is Zepfig.
Shh, stop talking. Mute. Much better. November of 2023 with this talk from the Linux Plumbers Conference from the developer, emulating ntsynchronization primitives in Wine. Now the dev claims some absolutely wild performance gains. Some of these, you know, 20% improvement for Metro 2033. Tiny Tina's Wonderland, 177% improvement. Dirt 3, 678%. That's a lot of numbers. That is a lot of FPS. Obviously, this is like, hey, best case scenario. Like, 20% is still nice, right? Like, 700% though, like, it's going to be a very special kind of game that really relies on this to see something like that. Now, the first sign of hope came a bit later in April of 2024 alongside the 6.10 kernel. 6.10 to merge NTSync driver for emulating Windows NT synchronization primitives. Again, showing that same graph from earlier. Now, at this time, the driver seemed like it was in a state to merge. Emphasis, very heavy emphasis on seemed, because whilst those patches were merged at the time, calling them ready is not the phrase that I would use. So Greg Crower Hartman did this. Mark driver as broken to prevent from building. The NT code is only partially enabled in the kernel at this point in time, creating the device node, and that's about it. Don't confuse systems that expect to see a working NTSync interface by teasing it with this basic structure at this point in time. So mark the code as broken so that it is not built and enabled just yet. Once the rest of the code is accepted, this will be reverted so that the driver can be correctly built and used, but for now, this is the safest way forward. So basically, it was enabled a little bit prematurely. NTSync, like the basically the Hello World version of NTSync, had been merged into the kernel, but the rest of it was still yet to be merged. The patch set was most of the way done, it just was sitting in the mailing list, ready to be actually, you know, brought into the kernel. And the developer, they just agreed, because they realized it was not merged either. I was even thinking of suggesting something like this myself. Sorry for taking so long to get the rest of the patches into an acceptable shape. Completely reasonable. Yeah, it just makes sense. They got certain pieces merged enough where it could be built, but it just wasn't entirely ready yet. Much like fsync in its prior state before, you would see projects that were going ahead and shipping ntsync. Notably, you had this from Pharonix about CatchyOS. I think it's funnier just to never do a video on CatchyOS. There's so many people around me who are like, hey, CatchyOS is great. You should try out CatchyOS. But yeah, CatchyOS, they did have the NT-Sync stuff working a little bit before it was fully ready in the upstream kernel. They just went and like merged the patches themselves. And this post was released on December 25th, Christmas last year. At 3 a.m.? Surely that's not Michael's actual time zone that he published this at. Unless he queued it up. Regardless, now, as of a few days ago, it is ready to be merged into the 6.14 window when that opens up later this month. So, it's not entirely clear when distros like Ubuntu are going to see this, because again, Arch, gonna have it pretty much straight away, Gentoo, things like that, anything with a rolling kernel, gonna get it pretty quickly. I don't know if it will make it to the window for Ubuntu 25.04. It would be cutting it pretty close, but sometimes I like to go like a version or so back and then go from there. Also, actually, it's an LTS release, so it actually would be an LTS kernel, so probably you'd be waiting until 25.10 for things like Ubuntu. But Fedora, they'll have the kernel relatively quickly and a bunch of other things, and yeah, hopefully the numbers actually play out somewhat like this in the real world. Obviously, yes, most games aren't getting a 700% improvement. Most games will be like 5-10%, which, depending on the game, might actually be noticeable. But I would like my 700%. At least, you know, 20 or 30% when looking at games like Monster Hunter Wilds. I know they've done a lot of performance improvements since the beta build they did a couple of months back, and hopefully by release we actually see it in a much, much better state than it was, but oh my god, that beta was very rough. Holy shit, that was so bad. Game was fun, just garbage performance. So, let me know your thoughts down below. Are you a Linux gamer? If you are, what games do you play? Personally, I've been playing a lot of Marvel Rivals. On the PS5, playing a little Stellar Blade. A very fun game. Highly recommend it. Got some interesting costume designs. Also Yakuza. Big Yakuza fan. Very excited for Pirate Yakuza. Anyway, let me know down below. So, if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Libera Pay link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and gaming.